Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. I'm your host, Masses32210, and today I'm repurposing junk. What I'm doing is I need to build some kind of road grader. This can also be good for fields, driveways, anything, any kind of dirt or such soil, hard pan, whatever you're trying to straighten out. You want to kind of level it, fill in the holes. This is supposed to help kind of knock the high spots off and redistribute the material back into the lower spots to smooth it out. I have about half mile, I believe, of road that I own, which is shared by one neighbor. It's gotten horrible. My driveway is getting a couple spots. So today I'm actually repurposing junk, and I'll show you behind me what we're actually using. You can use something similar or build it from scratch, but I try to do the things on the cheapest as possible. So why don't we turn this camera around and let's look at what I got. All right, what you're looking at is part of an old frame for a boat trailer that I've had probably 6 years. The axle completely screwed up on this unit, or the leaf spring screwed up, then the axle, but basically it became junk. I have, as you see, I've cut pieces out and I've used it for other projects. Repurposed it. So what I have is this left. I would dug this out the weeds. The previous owner, before I made it into just a semi flat deck, they had actually made it into a super heavy flat deck. When I mean heavy, they had 2x material laying across, I believe 2x6s. That's why you see the last remnants of bolts and there's holes everywhere, which the only thing I'm going to do is come through with a with a cutoff wheel. I'm gonna snip all them off because I'm not gonna need those bolts, and my goal is to smooth things out, not just keep, like, even though that would be good to tear up the material, I'm gonna do it a different way. So those are all gonna be removed. Let me see about taking it all off the stand so we can get a closer look. There's bolts everywhere. Those are just gonna be zipped off. And here's part of the tongue. And I believe they said at one point this was a tilt trailer. I'm not sure on that. I know they had 2 stainless bolts going through here that held the tongue, which was almost equivalent to what you see here. I just went ahead and unbolted that because this piece already is super heavy as it is. What I plan on doing is I'm going to go ahead and cut it on these lines. We're going to remove this front portion. I don't need that. I'm going to try to repurpose this chain. I have the safety hook chains from there. What else we get? I repurposed some of the stainless hardware I found. That'll be good for repurposing. What I'm going to basically do is I'm going to make this, because you can see this little L. I'm going to make this side is going to be the side that's dragging on the ground and cutting. That way I can use this little kick up to my advantage, so that way this will sit up a little higher. So I'm just going to leave a little tongue on this. First things first, I guess what I'll do is go ahead and snip this very front off and whiz off all these bolts. Go ahead and try to get it flatter, and I guess we'll see on the next clip.
So far what I got accomplished, I went ahead and just grabbed some old angle iron, which is not but old bed frames that I had lying around, so they were another freebie. Trying to figure out how to exactly what I want. I want the front, which I wish the front now that was wider, but I think this should work. I took one piece and I notched it in, and those are some ugly welds. This stuff is hard for my welder to weld through, but right now really it's just tacked in. I was also thinking in the future, if this works, I can drill a hole straight through here. Since this is nothing more than the C-channel, I could just put a bolt to bolt the center in, put a spacer in between these two, and tighten that down right in the center. But I've got it tacked in. I have it, seven-eighths protruding off so I can get a good deep cut. Then I forgot the exact width of this up here in the front. But the back is, I've kind of kept it exactly as the frame, and I've tacked this piece in, and I believe it's like a half inch. Theory, the front's going to cut and the rear is going to smooth. That's my basic theory. Also, I went through, cut off all the extra bolts. You can see them down there. They're in just a giant pile. So that's all for the garbage. This is DIY. This is more just brainstorming and just repurposing. If this works, I didn't really have nothing in it. Reused this one of the stainless bolts. Took the chain. For right now, just put a quarter inch bolt, and I bolted all three pieces of chain that were recycled from this unit. And the reason is I want to be able to hook this around the bowl on my ATV and latch it through. But I want, because of the certain parts of the road get narrow for when I have to turn around, I want it where I can be able to do a U-turn and not have it dead on my tail on the ATV.
Well, I figured no better time than now to try it. This is like first thing in the morning. It's like 7 in the morning. I know, by a matter of fact, as I'm talking to you guys, I see my neighbors. They're scooting on by, which is a good thing. So since there nobody's going to be on my end of the road, I figured why not. Let's go ahead and I'll hook this up to the ATV. We're going to go ahead and give it a try and see how it performs. Worst case scenario, I pop one of the tack welds loose. But also, I want to go ahead and grab a couple other tools, and I'll show you why once I get out there to the road. And what I decided is I'm going to go ahead and drag the other half of my driveway out to the road, because I'm starting to get a couple little holes in it. So I figured why not, we'll just drag it from there, and I'll show you what we have to do as far as road repair while we're out there. Well, for the first pass, I was going about 3 miles an hour. It really, really wasn't bad. Now, I knew what was done to the road before I acquired it. I knew it was going to end up being an issue. And I'm walking you down there. Here's one of the spots. Well, how about this? I'll just point you down here. What the gentleman used to do is anytime a bad hole would form, he would throw rocks in, which was a good idea. Here's one spot, and you can see a little bit of rubble in this hole. Here's some more here, and it's spotty down the road. And I figured what was going to happen is any of the spots that there's rubble. See, we got one spot right here. There would be stuff like this thrown in the road, which is okay. In theory, it's a good idea. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to put them off to the side of the road, and I'll come back with a bucket. And I think for super low spots, I'll replant them in super low spots. So as I drag, it will pack the hole back in with something. But like right here, it's getting a bad hump. There's right there. I don't know if you can see it. I think this will actually work. It's not doing too bad. Now, here's another low spot. So far, it's not doing bad. But I think what I'm going to do is up the ante. And you can see, here's my ATV right here. And this is why I left such a long chain, so I can try to turn around. Now, I did drag this out of the road a little bit in case somebody does have to come by. So I think what I'm going to do, so we can keep more pressure down on that cutting edge, for the most part, it seems like it's doing like what I expected. The back is knocking it down. The front is cutting in. I'll unhook from the ATV. I'm going to go grab a cinder block. You know what? I might as well continue. I might as well actually just continue dragging this towards there. And we'll grab a cinder block, or I can grab two and a ratchet strap. And let's see how it performs with
maybe a cinder block up here, and if I have to, I'll build a bracket and weld it in to actually put more downward pressure on this cutting edge. Well, guys, I started around 7. It's 11:07 now. Now, not only did I do my portion of the road, I done my entire driveway. I went ahead and also done straight down to the neighbor's gates, which they have like 40 acres right after me. I ran into my neighbor, and she was so ecstatic, like how smooth the road was on our half. She even said she would pay me to just take care of it all the way to the gate. And I told her, no, it's not about money. It's about being neighbors. I was like, I'm going to do this anyway. So I'm going to go ahead and take care of that end of the road. So as well as I've done the entire road that I own, I've done my driveway. I didn't film it, but I went down to the beginning of the road where two other gentlemen, the neighbors, they bring their tractors out. And I've noticed that nobody's touched the very beginning of the road. And that's where there's a lot of divots and bumps, and I did it the best I could to knock it down. One thing I realized with this, the speed controls what you're doing. 1 to 3 miles an hour, I'm able to get a good solid dig where the front, that front blade, what did I say, was 7/8 is what I left it down. With the cinder block and the weight of the frame, it's able to really dig in. Let me see if I can get y'all. Now, if you notice, I still have some dirt, which I'll just rake that out. On the back, the bar, the little smoothing bar actually came loose, but it was still an advantage. The welds broke. There's a lot of rocks that were in the road, so I kept, I guess, knocking them loose. As I would knock them loose, I would stop the ATV, get out, throw them off to the side of the road. In my driveway, I do have little rocks of hard pan, which that's not an issue. But I think I'm just going to leave it as is. So far, this works perfect. It really cuts the dirt, helps grade it out in that natural C channel. This stuff's so thick and it is galvanized, so I'm only going to add paint to wherever I weld it just to keep it from rusting through. Other than that, this has become a perfect road drag. You got to love junk. The only thing I really have invested is welding wire. Other than that, works perfect. Give me a thumbs up if you like this. Try not to make too much video of it dragging, just to make it mundane, the same thing. As you noticed, I did speed up the footage of just dragging it, just so we're not sitting there forever. But it works perfect for me. I love it. Now I can keep my property, and not just my property, maintained to help the neighbors, so we're not bouncing around killing our vehicles. Thank you guys. Thumbs up for sure. I appreciate every last one of you.